האחים המנגינות של אחים האחיות. מבראשית הכל תפור, פלאים פלאים של הסיפור, ושתי מילים להתחבר לחוצב של משורר.
Oh my gosh, unbelievable. Yeah. It is just a cornucopia of riches this morning. Wow. How much fun is this? Hi.
Welcome everyone to Yom HaTzmaut. If you are not speaking as part of the ceremony, please be on mute. Thank you, and I'm going to turn it over to our hosts, Maya Hertig and Yonatan Hasidim.
ברוכים הבאים לחגיגות יום העצמאות, ה-73 של מדינת ישראל.
Shalom, everyone. Welcome to the torch ceremony celebrating Israel 73.
השנה אנו חוגגים 73 שנים לעצמאותה של מדינת ישראל, שהנושא הוא אחווה ישראלית. היום אנו מתכנסים כקהילה לראות את אחדותנו ואהבתנו למדינת ישראל.
This year we are not only celebrating 73 years of Israel's independence, but also focusing on the specific theme, a nation coming together. Our community, we gathered here to show and celebrate our love for Israel.
אתמול ציינו את יום הזיכרון, ואם היינו ביחד, היינו מורידים את הדגל לחצי התורן. היום אנחנו עוברים מעצב לשמחה, לחגיגות עצמאות של מדינת ישראל.
Yesterday we commemorated Yom HaZikaron and lowered the flag to half staff. Today together we will transition from that sadness to celebrate the life of Israel and raise the flag back up.
לפני שנתחיל בטקס עצמו, ברצוננו לומר תפילה לשלום מדינת ישראל.
Before we begin with the official ceremony, we would like to say a prayer for the state of Israel.
אנו מתכבדים להזמין את מאיה רוזנברג.
We would like to invite Maya Rosenberg to recite a prayer.
Today, as we transition from a day of mourning and sadness into a day of celebration and joy, let us say a prayer for the state of Israel. Avinu in heaven and on earth, rock and redeemer of Israel, bless the state of Israel, the beginning of our redemption. Shield it beneath the wings of your steadfast love and spread over it the shelter of your peace. May a spark of your spirit inspire the actions of its leaders, officials, judges, healers, protectors, educators, innovators, and advisors, that they may follow the path of righteousness, liberty, and freedom. Strengthen the hands of those who build and protect our holy land and grant them salvation and life. Grant peace to this land and everlasting joy to its inhabitants.
בכל שנה מתקיים בישראל טקס המשואות המסורתי, שמסמל את המעבר מיום הזיכרון ליום העצמאות. בישראל, האנשים נבחרים מדליקים 12 משואות שמסמלות את 12 השבטים. זו הפעם העשירית שיש לנו טקס משואות בבית הספר פרק בחגיגות יום העצמאות. הנושא המרכזי בשנה זו הוא אחווה ישראלית. 6 אנשים שתרמו רבות בשנה האחרונה למאבק בקורונה, יכובדו היום
בחגיגת
משואה. אנחנו מודים להם על תרומתם ועל אהבתם לארץ ישראל.
There is a special tradition in Israel, Tekes HaMasuot, the torch ceremony, which takes place every year at the end of Yom HaZikaron and which marks the opening of Yom HaTzmaut. In Israel, the lighting of 12 torches, symbolizing the 12 tribes, marks the center of the festivities. A different theme is chosen annually for the torch ceremony. 12 torchbearers are carefully selected in compliance with the theme. The theme chosen for this year is a nation coming together. 6 Israeli frontline workers and civilians will be honored today with the lighting of a torch during this ceremony to honor their commitment to the safety and well-being of Israel, as well as their coping with the pandemic in months of lockdown. We recognize them and thank them for their contributions, deeds, and actions of Ahava Israel, the love of Israel.
להדלקת המשואה הראשונה, אנו מתכבדים להציג את דוקטור טילי פישר יוסף.
To light the first torch, we are honored to introduce Dr. Tilly Fisher Yosef of the Maccabi Health Clinic in Kfar Yona.
Hello and happy Yom HaAtzmaut, Barak students. My name is Dr. Tilly Fisher Yosef. I'm a primary care physician in the Maccabi Health Clinic in Kfar Yona in Israel, next to Netanya, and I'm a mother of three little children. During this pandemic, I was a primary care physician here, took care of all my COVID-19 patients and also patients all over the country, calling them every day to see how they are, giving them their medication, referring them to the hospital if needed. Also, I've been distributing vaccinations. You know, here in Israel, we have over 4 million people that already got the vaccine, and I'm very optimistic. I'm also part of a research to see the antibodies in people who already got the Pfizer vaccine, and maybe we'll have enough data to share with you, with the whole world. I wish you all health, and I wish us all to meet each other, you know, in the States or here in Israel, all in good health, no masks on.
Yeah, I'm just watching it. I'm not really listening to it.
You need to come and light the masua.
Lighting this torch in honor of Dr. Tilly Fisher Yosef and all the doctors who have worked tirelessly to help treat coronavirus and who have saved thousands of lives. And me, Sarah Yosef Spivak, Madhika Masua, Zorikro, Dr. Tilly Fisher Yosef, the Kol HaRofim, Shavdu Bli Hapsaka, Kidei Lazor, Bitipul Corona, Shavdu Alfei Chaim.
להדלקת המשואה השנייה, אנו מתכבדים להציג את גברת טליה קספי.
To light the second torch, we are honored to introduce Ms. Talia Kaspi, middle school student from Afeka, Tel Aviv.
Hi, I'm Talia Kaspi. I'm 14 years old from Tel Aviv, Israel. אני מדליקה משואה זו on behalf of all of the Israeli students that haven't been able to attend school for a year now due to COVID. I want to wish you all, Barak students, Yom HaAtzmaut Sameach.
Hi, Abby Greenson. I'm lighting this torch in honor of Ms. Talia Kosky and all of the young children who've had to stay in their home for the past year and kept up their education and entertain themselves in these hard times. Ani, Abby Greenson, Madlika Masua, Zolik Vod Giberet Talia Kosky, Bikola Yeladim Shehayu Chayavim, Mishair Babay Hashana Ha'achona, והמשיכו את החינוך שלהם, והמשיכו לענות במשך השנה הקשה הזאת.
להדלקת המשואה השלישית, אנו מתכבדים להציג את גברת גלית לוי.
To light the third torch, we are honored to introduce Ms. Galit Levy of the Ladies Circle Haifa Association.
Hello, Barak students. Happy Yom HaAtzmaut. My name is Galit Levy, and I'm a mother of five living in Haifa. In my spare time, I volunteer in Ladies Circle Haifa Association. We are a group of women, all are hardworking mothers that find the time to give from themselves to the community. During COVID, we helped lots of needed children, women, lonely soldiers, and Holocaust survivors with supplies of masks, medicine, and food deliveries. In Purim, we provide costumes and mishpoche manot. And in Passover, food for the Seder, as well as many others. The attention and support we are giving enable them to overcome difficulties and to have the feeling that they are not alone in the world. In my other capacity, I'm a lactation guide and help those with food. Section and truly free love. Love you all.
I, Talia Backman, am lighting this torch in honor of Ms. Galit Levy, who volunteers at the Women's Circle in Haifa, as well as all the other volunteers who have helped the Israeli community in numerous ways. Ani Talia Vakin, Malika Eta Mesua, Zolik Vod Hagiverat Galit Levi, Shemit Nadevet Bahug Hanashim Bahaifa, Bekol Mit Nadvim Sha'azru La Kehila HaYisraeli, Badrachim Rabim Lemesech Corona.
להדלקת המסור הרביעי, אנו מתכבדים להציג את גברת רחל מרקוב רוזנברג.
To light the fourth torch, we are honored to introduce Ms. Rachel Marco Rosenberg of the Reina Neim School in Zichron Yaakov.
Hello, happy Yom HaAtzmaut to all the BRAC students. My name is Rachel Rosenberg. I'm a counselor in a special education school for students who suffer from behavioral and emotional problems. I'm a mother of three, and I live in Yokneam, Moshavat, Israel. I'd like to share with you the last year in the COVID crisis. I went to school every single day. Going to school every morning, leaving my kids at home when all the other schools are closed, leaving them with their father, means the world. It means going to school and giving all the support to my students, giving all the support to the teachers and staff in school so they can give the support to the students. Our students on a regular basis need emotional support, behavioral support, and even when there's not a global crisis, every day is a struggle. So happy Yom HaAtzmaut.
I'm Matthew Garber, and lighting this torch in honor of Rachel and Markel Rosenberg, a middle school counselor in Israel, as well as all of the other counselors who have helped so many people during this hard time. Ani Matthew Garber, Ali Mizua, Zolik Vod, Rachel Markel Rosenberg, Yo'ezet Hatikva Benayim, Bekol Ha Yotzim, Sazru Le Kol Kaf, Harban Hashim, Ba'azaman, Hakasher Hazer.
להדלקת המשואה החמישית, אנו מתכבדים להציג את גברת אסתר מרקס.
It has been quite a tough year. I work in the situation. We are here to help people cope, to help people deal with uncertainty and locate the resources and see that they can get through this pandemic, which has been very tough. But as with 20 years of receiving rockets, et cetera, from the other side, we have discovered that we have the most amazing ability to cope and function and to stay positive and to get through with a little help from our friends. Thank you so much for taking an interest in us. And I wish you a huge, huge, healthy, happy Independence Day. And hope that you're also coping and doing what you've got to be doing as we are here too. Hi, this is... And I wish you a huge, huge, healthy, happy Independence Day. And hope that you're also coping and doing what you've got to be doing as we are here too. And we look forward to seeing you. Come out and visit whenever you can. Bye.
I, Leah DeLove, am lighting this torch in honor of Mrs. Esther Marcus and all of the therapists who spent so much time to help alleviate some of the emotional damages that the virus can cause and help uplift those that might need it. Ani, Leah DeLove, Madlika Masuazo, the Chod Kagveret, Esther Marcus, the Holha Mit Kalim, Shemakshiim, Mizmanim, Vozrima Nashim, Bekidila, Shenitzke'u, Nafshi, Ket, Totsa'ah, Mivirus HaKorona.
להדלקת המשואה השישית, אנו מתכבדים להציג את ליהי כהן, קצינת טירונים בחיל הים.
To light the sixth torch, we are honored to introduce Lehi Cohen, class of 2018, a platoon commander in the Israeli Navy.
Hi, my name is Lehi Cohen. I'm a Barrack alumni. I graduated in 2018. I serve in the Navy. I'm a commander for basic training in the Navy. And during the time of Corona, the Army was not easy. We had new soldiers coming in every month from the real world, had to take extra care of them and make sure that they go home to their families and they don't harm them with any sort of sickness. But now most people are vaccinated and we're getting closer to coming back to reality. So I wish you all a happy Yom Ha'atzmaut. Celebrate, have fun, and hope to see you in Israel soon.
Hi, Leila Friedman. I'm lighting this torch in honor of Lehi Cohen and of all the soldiers of Tzahal for the continued service for Israel and the protection of the Jewish people. Ani Bela Friedman, Matzlika Masua Zo, Lipo Lehi Cohen, Bekola Chayelim Batzahal, Usheru Shalahan, Yishvil Yisrael, Vahakanat Tayehudi.
תודה רבה לכל מדליקי הנשואות על המחויבות שלהם לעזור לישראל להילחם בקורונה. תודה לבתם למדינת ישראל.
We would like to thank all of our honorees for their commitment and dedication and their love of the state of Israel.
בנוסף לרופאים, אחים, מורים, מתנדבים, יועצים וחיילים, מסיימים אחווה ישראלית, יש גם אומנים שנרתמו בכדי לעודד את הציבור בישראל. בואו נהנה מהשיר קטן עלינו שנכתב בכדי להעלות את המורל במדינה.
In addition to the doctors, nurses, teachers, volunteers, counselors, and soldiers who represent a nation coming together, we also count on terrific artists who collaborated in this song, Katan Aleinu, We Got This, to help improve the morale of the people of Israel.
על הים התיכון הגלים פה לא שקטים זה אומר המון
מהחול של הנקב ועד החמור בית חם ופה כולם אומרים שלום
מול כל מכשול וכל חידה עוד תקוותנו לא עבדה
מה יוליד יום זאת לא נדע ועל הכל נאמר תודה כמו שהיה ככה יהיה עברנו הכל נעבור גם את זה
לא יפלו פנינו זה קטן עלינו
כמו שהיה ככה יהיה עברנו הכל נעבור גם את זה
לא יפלו פנינו זה קטן עלינו קפה במרפסת ריחות של שבת איך כולנו פה אותו דבר כמעט שמוע לדגש
כולנו אש, אין לנו פחד. ככה בטוח יהיה לנו קל. מול כל מכשול וכל חידה עוד תקוותנו לא עבדה
מיוליד יום זאת לא נדה ועל הכל לומר
And finally, another way that a nation comes together is by finding the good, even in challenging times. Please listen to this presentation from social entrepreneur Ra'ut Benjamin before we welcome her live to take a few questions.
Please note that at points, Ra'ut is very upfront about the struggles she's faced. The experiences she lists may be upsetting to some. Nonetheless, please be open to the message of resilience and optimism that she shares.
Seeking out, what is also good here? Hello, everyone. I am Ra'ut Benjamin, founder and leader of the Good News Initiative. Today, we celebrate the 73rd Independence Day of the State of Israel. And this is very good news. I assume you'll agree with me that the State of Israel is a miracle. It is a superpower and a home to every Jew as they are. And Israel has reached incredible and impressive accomplishments relative to its size and age. On Independence Day, we all recall this and are filled with a sense of pride, hope, and gratitude. But in the day-to-day, in our routine lives, if we open the news or follow current media, what do we seem to hear about the state of Israel? What kinds of updates on the country are we confronted with on a sweeping, daily, and ongoing basis? Whoever follows the various media channels knows that we mostly hear on the news about terror attacks, injuries, burglary, rape, demonstrations, murder, theft, corruption, polarization, and conflicts between different spheres or parties. In the news, we hear mainly about the negative things, the difficult and devastating happenings taking place in the world at large, and in Israel in particular. This reality has a tremendous effect on our lives, impacting us on the level of each individual as a Jew or Israeli in the world or in Israel, as well as socially as a collective, and certainly on a national scale. Research demonstrates that news consumption has negative effects on well-being, social trust, and education, distorts perceptions and role modeling, and primarily leaves us stuck within a negative feedback loop that only spirals deeper and deeper. Moreover, on a societal level, a looming sense seeps into the collective that the world in general, and Israel specifically, is a scary, dangerous, and evil place. This information causes tension, despair, depression, stress, and panic. It ignites hatred in society and causes us to lose faith in one another and to grow distant. Such is the outcome in practice when the negative generates even more negativity. Additionally, researchers of positive psychology discovered that one of the main causes of suffering in our current period is fixating on negative content. This is to say, it's not only that we hear about negative and difficult events in the news, but rather that we hear about them over and over and over to no end. When we hear something repeatedly, it transforms into something that holds influence on our lives and essentially takes on a determining role in shaping our experience. Instead of engaging in problem solving or finding constructive ways to navigate challenges, people perceive reality in distorted ways and are left feeling more afraid, hopeless, and helpless, since everything seems threatening and overwhelming. It's not a simple thing to live in a reality in which everything surrounding you is daunting and awful. I know this personally from my own life story, starting at age 5, when, with no advance notice or explanation, my father just disappears from my life. I'm left confused and terrified. And after several months, I lose my mother before my very eyes, when she chokes and I cannot save her. After that, I get a stepmother and stepbrother who abuse me physically, emotionally, and sexually. I live in a harsh reality, raising myself alone, until I marry at a young age. When I'm already a mother to a small boy, I experience a shooting attack in which terrorists shoot me and chase me down. Some years later, I leave the structure of the trying marriage I had been living through, and I'm forced to start my whole life over again, and I'm on my own with 4 children. This is what my world looked like. This was my life. But I will already reveal to you that I succeeded in navigating all of the difficult challenges in my life and lifting myself up from there through the gift of one thing alone, through the gift of one simple question that I had always been seeking an answer for from the time I was a little girl and would always ask myself, but what is also good here? What is also good here? This question has great power on our lives as individuals and as a society. It can change our lives for the better in expansive and far-reaching ways. Discovering the goodness. So let's return again to look at how we see the world and the state of Israel through the lens of the continuous news cycle. And let's ask, but what is also good here? Is there any good at all here also? Since the media hardly engages with good news, it's possible that at first glance, we may think there isn't much good news or any at all. The media, intentionally or not, has taught us that most of the world's events are negative and that there are very few positive things happening. And if they are indeed happening, they must be less important and less interesting. And this is not at all correct. Positive things are, in fact, happening all the time, and there is always good news. A thriving and healthy society or nation is one that is capable of always remembering and marking its points of strength and growth in order to give them expression and meaning, and thus to expand and cultivate them further. If we ignore something consistently, we essentially minimize its power by not giving it space in our lives. Therefore, we have even an obligation to bring the public on an ongoing daily basis the good news of Israel as well. This may look challenging in a complex reality, but it is possible, and it even becomes easier over time. This is something else I learned from my own life story. Since through each of the painful events I experienced and shared with you, I always asked myself, what is also good here? And so, I found it. From an unexplainable force within me, I always searched for something good to help me survive, a point of light to hold on to. And each time, I found it. For instance, when they told me my mother died and would not return, it was the absolute worst news I could have received. Yet alongside this, there was also the news they told me that I would return to my father. And when I did not have a warm home and family, there were always good friends by my side who were like family and a home to me. When I experienced a terror attack, I remembered that I was saved in the end by a miracle, that I'm still alive. And I have many more moments like those throughout my life's journey in which I remembered to search for and hold on to what is also good in my life, or what bit of good may spring forth from the bad. If I had not pursued what is also good in life, I would have been sucked into the negative and arrived at dangerous places. As a society and as a nation, it is incumbent on us to put an emphasis on good news, certainly in a reality in which the media channels give us terrible and difficult news most of the time, bombarding us with hours of stressful and frightening information and commentaries. As a collective, our good news is our power, our hope, our security, and our success. It is what will continue to move us forward from a more stable, healthy, and fruitful place. Alongside the negative things, which also serve a purpose and must be given exposure, we must create for ourselves the possibility to stay updated and be informed on an ongoing basis about the good news as well, in order to create balance and a healthier lifestyle overall. We've seen that it is possible even from the hardest places, since there is always something good. And this awareness itself already brings with it a positive effect. There is no one with whom I've shared good news who hasn't smiled, been joyful, and felt hope and pride in their heart. Good news is compelling and fascinating. Consider, for instance, that Israel stands at the world record for altruistic giving, with over 1,000 kidney donations to strangers in 2021. A historic first economic collaboration has taken place between Israel and Sudan. For the first time in history, a Holocaust Memorial Day ceremony was held in an Arabic country. Linoy Ashram, gold medalist, and Moran Samuel, silver medalist, among many other accomplished athletes, bring Israel great pride in international competitions. When Israeli high schoolers' trip to Poland was canceled, they instead set out to renovate the homes of elderly citizens. The city of Tel Aviv is ranked as one of the most delicious cities in the world. A bus driver returned a wallet with 70,000 shekel to its owner. And there are so many more pieces of good news. The ones above are only from the last week. Doesn't it make you feel good when you hear this good news? That's why I say that even hearing them already creates a positive effect. Consistently allowing, letting the good lead the way. But the effect doesn't end here and doesn't need to end here, since I know that if we can hear Israel's good news on a daily basis and spread it, we can also make an impact. When we consume positive content, we grow to become creators of positive content. Good news is our individual and societal resilience, giving us hope and pride and advancing unity and closeness. But they also provide inspiration and motivation to get involved and take action. When I understood that this was my superpower, and that from an early age, I focused on what was also good, despite the challenging circumstances, in order to move forward and not to fall, I began to also create more goodness for myself. And when that happened, I understood that as a society as well, this can be our superpower. And so, from a small and scared child, a girl with no home, and a woman starting her life from square one against all odds, I transformed over the past few years to becoming an educator with 2 degrees in managerial educational practice, a lecturer throughout Israel and internationally, a communications woman and radio broadcaster, a narrator and facilitator, a model, and most importantly, a social entrepreneur. More than any other role I've performed in recent years, I am proudest to be the person who established and stands at the head of the Good News Initiative. Influencing, inspiring more good. The goal of the Good News Initiative is to empower our individual, societal, and national resilience through a large platform for good news, both broadcasting it and creating more of it. 3 years ago, I began on this journey, and with my own two hands, I started to spread good news that came to my ears, and the demand for good news keeps growing, with more and more people joining the movement. Today, I operate through four channels, a Facebook group, a Facebook page, the website Homies, and the radio. On all these platforms, we have over 120,000 followers. I operate without hesitation in order to find and spread the good news that is happening in real time. And along with me, several others have joined the mission, understanding its great importance and our need for good news. I already have received hundreds of messages from people sharing that this good news is making a positive difference in their lives, that they feel more relaxed, more empowered, more optimistic, and full of motivation to take part and have an influence themselves. There are people who tell me that it helps them grapple with anxiety and depression. There are also stories of people who understood the power of unity and giving and succeeded in overcoming disparities and connecting to people they never thought they would meet. The Good News Initiative shouts out our pride and our power in a strong voice, filling us with a sense of security, hope, and confidence. My vision is still large, and through it, I maintain the collection of good news that operates independently and brings and creates good news for the masses, shaping interconnectedness and belonging. Today, I am developing a social model that will bring the good news in the best, most professional, high quality, and accessible way. Within the model I'm building, there's also one of my dreams, which is that in every Israeli or Jewish school in the world, they will open each day with good news about Israel in order to strengthen and maintain the connection and affinity between Israel and Jews all over the world. Good news is perhaps the most fitting point of connection for preserving deep ties between the Jewish people and its land. I'll close with this. There are many ways to deal with the negative and to fight it. The most effective way is to engage with and shed light on the positive as much as possible. And I will ask of you to take away one sentence from here, a sentence for you to recite and remember at every opportunity you have throughout your life, or through every newscast or societal happening you're part of. Always, but always, there is also something good. All you need is to seek out what is also good here, to discover, here, this is good, to allow, to give space for the good, and to influence. Be a creator of more good. In Israel, we say on Independence Day, to the splendor of the state of Israel. So, good news is exactly that, the beautiful splendor of the state of Israel. And it is on us to make them known all the time, and the more, the better. Happy Independence Day.
Now we would like to welcome Ruth to answer any questions anyone may have. If you have a question, please let us know in the chat or ask your advisor to unmute the device in your room, introduce yourself, and ask.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
רעות, אני קודם כל רוצה לברך אותך בהצגה מקסימה ובמיזם מקסים וישר כוח, כל הכבוד, ואנחנו מחכים לעוד חדשות טובות. אז קודם כל ברוכה הבאה לבית הספר שלנו והמון המון תודה שאת כאן איתנו.
Thank you. תודה רבה לכם.
Is there still time?
Does somebody have a question?
Let me ask you a question, Reut. So how do you get to those news? Do you have people around you that just, you know, forward good news to you? How do you decide what to publish and what not to publish?
Okay. This is a good question, and this is a lot of work and thinking about how to bring the good news and which good news I can bring to a lot of people. There is a lot of work behind all the things that I do. There is also and other people that help me. And I tried, אני אעבור קצת לעברית באמצע, בסדר? ומי שיכול לתרגם אותי. ובעצם, כשהתחלתי לתת חדשות טובות, התחילו להכיר אותי כזאת שנותנת חדשות טובות להרבה אנשים, והרבה אנשים התחילו להצטרף. ואז גם הרבה מקומות והרבה ארגונים וחברות ודוברויות התחילו לשלוח לי את החדשות הטובות כדי שאני אפרסם אותם להרבה אנשים, כי ידעו שיש אנשים שעוקבים ומתעניינים ושאני מביאה חדשות טובות. אז ככה התחלתי להיות מין איזשהו צינור כזה שמקבל אליו המון המון חדשות טובות. זה כמובן היה תהליך ועדיין זה תהליך וזה דורש המון המון עבודה, אבל זה כבר קורה. ואיזה חדשות טובות לתת, זאת שאלה שאני ואנשים שעושים איתי את זה, אנחנו הרבה מאוד פעמים לוקחים החלטות ממש במקום, ומנסים ככה להביא את החדשות הטובות בשפה שלנו, בצורה שהיא מתאימה לנו. צריך לדעת איך לעשות חדשות טובות, זאת עבודה לא פשוטה, אבל היא אפשרית והיא חשובה, ואנחנו עושים אותה יום-יום. זאת עבודה באמת יום-יומית.
So I'm just going to translate the big ideas. So one of the things that you were saying that as you started spreading good news, more and more people got to know you and different groups and different people approached you and start sending you the good news, so you will spread it out more and more. And you're saying that it is difficult to find which news to publish and which not. It's involved with a lot of work. Some of the good news you really want to publish at the spot when it's hot from the press. And it's you're thinking with the team what is appropriate and what it's not to publish to the group of people that you're spreading the news to. So thank you so much.
Thank you.
There have been a number of really good questions that we're probably not going to be able to ask all of them, but there's one group that is wondering about tips for success to seeing the positive. What tips can you share with us?
אוקיי, אני, זה כמה דברים ככה, קודם כל שגם ככה העברתי אותם בהרצאה, בהרצאונת הקטנה שהעברנו פה. בעצם אתם שואלים איזה טיפים אפשר לתת שבעצם קשורים לטוב, נכון? אז זה כמו שאמרתי שם, אנחנו צריכים כל הזמן קודם כל לזכור, ללכת עם המשפט הזה כל הזמן בתוכנו, אבל מה גם טוב פה? אנחנו צריכים, לפני שאנחנו הולכים לישון, לשאול את עצמנו מה טוב היה לנו היום. בהקשר של החדשות הטובות שאני עושה, זה ממש להביא חדשות טובות ברמה לאומית, ברמה חברתית של כולנו, וכל הזמן לחפש מה גם טוב קורה בעולם שלנו, בחיים שלנו, בחברה שלנו. אני מאמינה שאנחנו מוצאים את מה שאנחנו מחפשים. לכן כל הזמן תלכו עם השאלה הזאת. מה גם טוב פה? כשאנחנו רואים משהו טוב, לתת לו את המקום ולתת לו את הבמה, לא לזלזל בו, ולא לעשות אותו פחות חשוב. יש לנו מין נטייה ללכת כל הזמן לשלילי. זה משהו גם שהוא מולד, וגם קצת העולם שבחוץ לא עושה איתנו, לא עושה לנו הרבה טובות עם זה. אז לתת לו מקום, ולתת לו להשפיע בחיים שלנו. אנחנו בעצם נותנים בעצם השפעה למה שאנחנו מכניסים לתוכנו, למה שאנחנו מחפשים אותו, למה שאנחנו דואגים לראות ולהסתכל. אז הכי הכי חשוב זה לזכור שתמיד, אבל תמיד יש גם משהו טוב. וכשאני אומרת תמיד יש משהו טוב, צריך לזכור שהטוב הוא הרבה פעמים מתוך הפחות טוב. יש טוב לצד הרע, יש טוב מתוך הרע, ואני ממליצה להביא את זה תמיד גם לאיזשהו משהו שהוא החוצה ממני. אחרי שהבנתי מה קרה לי טוב, או איזה טוב היה לצד הרע, לעשות עם זה משהו החוצה למען החברה. עכשיו, למען החברה זה לא חייב להיות מיזם חברתי כמו שאני מקימה, שזה מיזם שהחזון שלו הוא בינלאומי, ואנחנו ככה עושים המון המון עבודה, זה יכול להיות משהו מאוד ספציפי וקטן לכל אחד מאיתנו, במהלך היום-יום שלנו, מול בן אדם אחד אפילו. זה יכול להיות כמובן מול הקהילה, ומול בכלל, השמיים הם הגבול. אבל תמיד לזכור מה גם טוב פה, לחפש. וכשמתחילים לחפש את זה, זה כבר מגיע בקלות, כבר, זה כמו שקרה לי עם החדשות הטובות. בהתחלה הייתי צריכה לחפש חדשות טובות. היום אני כבר באומס מכל כך הרבה חדשות טובות שאני מקבלת כל הזמן, ואנחנו מבינים שאנחנו יכולים להקים גוף של חדשות טובות, של החדשות הטובות של ישראל, שיש לו הרבה מאוד תפקידים חשובים בעולם.
אכן כן. אז אני רק אסכם את כל הדברים. So I'm just going to summarize in a few sentences what you were saying. So first of all, guys, yes, we are surrounded with negative things, but you have to find the place and the time to find the good things. You also have to ask yourself, what is the good thing inside that situation? Let's focus on the good thing. Let's go to sleep and ask yourself, what was good in that day? What was good in this situation? And give a spot, give a place for the good things. Inspire others and spread it, of course. So we would say many, many things right now, but we are running out of time, unfortunately. Thank you so much. We truly appreciate you being with us and sharing this wonderful project. And I think that we're taking a lot with us today. Focus on the good, in the good. There's always something good in every situation. We need to give it a stage. Thank you. תודה רבה לך וחג שמח.
ותשמעו חדשות טובות של מדינת ישראל. זה כל כך חשוב.
נכון מאוד.
תודה רבה.
Thank you. ברצוננו להזמין את גברת לדין, מנהלת בית הספר, לומר מילות סיום.
We are honored to invite Ms. Levin, our head of school, to conclude our ceremony.
Thank you so much. I especially found what Ray Oot just talked about to be so inspiring, especially at this time of COVID. We have much to learn as individuals and as a school from her message. I want to say mazel tov, Torch honorees. And it was especially wonderful for me to see Leahy. Last evening, I was honored to watch a community celebration that Barrack helped sponsor as we move from Yom HaZikaron to Yom HaAtzma'ut. The program started with the plaintive song most of us know, I'll Call Ela, written by Naomi Shemer, who wrote Yerushalayim Shel Zahav. I'll Call Ela truly transitions us over all these things, over the honey and the stinger, over the bitter and the sweet. we commemorate the Yom Zeferek, Yom HaShoah, Yom HaZikaron, and today, Yom HaAtzma'ut. For many in Israel, these are truly their high holidays. I have been blessed to be in Israel for these special days and to witness how Israelis move between them. There is something almost schizophrenic to watch a nation move from a day of mourning right into a night of celebration. The very hat I am wearing, I bought off the head of an Israeli on the Tayelet, the boardwalk in Tel Aviv, on that transitional night in 1998, when I was in Israel celebrating Israel's 50th, the exact day that my husband turned 50, and he just had to have this hat. This has been an exceptional year for all of us. As I put on my Yom HaAtzma'ut shirt this morning and focused on the amazing image, the theme of a nation coming together suffused me with Ahavat Yisrael, love of Israel. Maya Rosenberg led us in a prayer where we blessed the researchers and scientists in Israel working to combat the coronavirus. And what could be more appropriate today than to honor in our tekes, our ceremony, Israel's frontline workers. Their resilience and fortitude, along with Israel's mass vaccination effort, is a model for all of us. I would like to recognize and thank those who made Yom HaZikaron and Yom HaAtzma'ut so special for us here at Barak. I have no doubt that I will leave someone out, but I must start with Meryl Sussman. Ms. Sussman has the very challenging position of Director of Israel Education Experiences and Special Projects. We are never quite sure exactly what that means, but we are quite sure that if Ms. Sussman is in charge, we can accomplish anything. I would like to say todah rabah to Maya Rosenberg, Akiva Weiss, Angela Zonshine, Liat Kirka, Abby Shaposhnik, Rebecca Wilson, Maya Koval, Maya Hertik, to those from the Israel Club who were in the videos, Leah Dolev, Bela Friedman, Matt Garber, Abby Greenspan, Sariella Spivak, Talia Vaknin. I'd like to thank Yonatan Hasidim, Mr. Dorsch, Spencer and Matt for their help, Rav Will. I'd like to thank Mark Rubin, who will be helping to run a music collective, Emmanuel Carmeli, who will be, leading with Dewey later, Tamar Azulai, the Hebrew department, the PE department, the JS department, Dewey, Danny Stein, all the teachers who, and it appears even out my window, that the rain, the Geshem has held off, but all the teachers who had to have lessons in place in case of rain. I'd like to thank on behalf of Mrs. Sussman, Mrs. Farrell, Mr. Cooper, Ms. Kalman, Mrs. Gronick, Susan Harding, Naeem, and Larry. I also want to recognize our outgoing Israel Club officers, Tamar Azulai, Emmanuel Carmeli, Maya Hertik, Mark Rubin, and Abby Shaposhnik. As we go through the day, many of us will be able to be involved in small group activities with our BICEP fellows from this year. So I want to thank ahead of time, Ari Abramovitz and Omri Sabar, who will deal with Israeli innovation, Roni Cohen and Leah Dolev talking about the IDF, Bela Friedman and Sariel Spivak on US-Israeli relations, and Rebecca Wilson on women and Zionism. since this is the last Yom HaAtzma'ut that I will be here with you as head of school, I feel that I can take the point of privilege, to go back to Israel 70 and the theme that the Israel Education Ministry chose that year. It seems especially relevant to what we have all experienced this past year and what we continue to experience. Chokrim et ha'avar, explore the past. Mokirim et ha'hoveh, cherish the present. Chozim et ha'atid, envision the future. On this Yom HaAtzma'ut in particular, we remember the past in the present for the purpose of building and securing our future. Thank you and Chag Sameach.
בסיום הטקס, כולם מתבקשים לעמוד לשירת התקווה.
To conclude this ceremony, we would like you all to stand for Israel's national anthem, Hatikva. Please sing along in your rooms.
Say clap now, clap and thank
you. Thank you guys. Thank you. Thank you.
תם טקס המשואות ל-2021. אנו מודים לכל מכובדינו ולכל האנשים שלקחו חלק בטקס. להתראות ויום עצמאות שמח לכולם.
Our torch ceremony has come to an end. We would like to thank all of our honorees and those who took part in our ceremony. We wish everyone a Yom HaAtzma'ut Sameach. Please remain on
the clap again.
Instructions from Ms. Sussman.
Thank you.
All right, yeah, so everybody unmute and say thank you and then listen for instructions.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay, so everybody breathe. We'll get a time to stretch and enjoy. I'm hoping that everybody picked up their badges. It will help them explain the rest of the day. We're moving to the 10:55 period. Sixth grade is in Hebrew. You can check the whiteboard for your places. Seventh and eighth grade are in your beach electives and the name tag will help you with that. Ninth and 10th grade is in the biceps electives, which the name tag will also help you with that. And 11th grade is with Hebrew and you should check the board. I'm hoping that explaining that first period will explain the rest of the day. There are schedules posted and also the stickers will help you and adults around. So go stretch and go get ready for the 10:55, either Hebrew, your beach elective, your bicep elective, or Hebrew for 11th grade. Yom HaAtzma'ut Sameach.
might be the next leader in my life.
Who?
You.
Oh, I don't know. Oh, okay. You mean Revola, because Revola's leaving?
Yeah. Because I'm in JLI. I know we'd really like it.